I've hosted a party in Trot. Smoothie. Yeah, okay. And the show again. Now, it was pretty decent. It'd be able to go forward in the war. Now, I just bring up that notice to me just a little. There you go. Now, see, like, just, you need to look forward. Now, you finished up in a little circle. Was that in your intention? Or did you just start off and have no plan on where you wanted to go?
That would have been an aspect of me getting
an engineering
training.
Okay. But, I mean, if I'm going to go to Trot, I'm going to think about, okay, where am I going to go first? Okay, then I'm going to pick her up and say, have I got your attention? Yep. Now I'm going to wind up now. I'm going to say, okay, let's start. Here's where we're going to go. You get what I mean?
Yes.
So many times people are going to go, get them going, then they start deciding where they're going. You know, so I'm going to know, I'm going to think, where am I going? How am I going? So if I'm going to ask her to trot, I'm going to put on a big circle, and then I'm going to, here I pick up her attention, here's my vision of where I want to go, okay, there's where we want to go. Okay? They need a little information, you know? Otherwise they got, you know, they're left guessing. Now, did you like the way that horse threw a nose up there? I didn't. I thought it was ordinary. You didn't do anything about it. Come on, get set the scene for yourself. Nose down, come to me with your nose, and now go forward with your feet. Right forward. Right to it. There. Good. Better. Okay, you on the correct diagram? Good girl. Now, nothing I would do with your horse, I'd get further up the pen, get away from these horses here. Don't let a cartoon down here to where, you know, down around these horses. It's a little harder to keep their attention if you're going to let them be down around these other horses, you know? And the center of pen, change the direction and change the diagonal, okay? Okay, that little passage across there was pretty good, huh? You had a lot more consistency of form, and consistency of rhythm. Pretty good. Now come on through the center, so change your diagonal, change your direction. So straighten up. Now I might, if I was you, just shorten my rein up a little bit and ask this horse there'd be a bit more continuity in the bridle, consistency in how to handle the bridle. You just let that horse be a little loose and a little inconsistent there. And you can improve it by shortening the rein up, be ready to help the horse be in the frame you want. Whatever you're letting the horse go around, Bobby's nose up and down, and that's going to become the standard for what that horse is going to do. I didn't let him do that. Now, I've been noticed when I drive this semi around before, I'm getting a little bit more along with the rein, a little bit more casual with her, because I've got her to where she understands I'm not going to put up with that stuff. And she's being more consistent about her form. And you always got to get yourself in a body position where you can control and monitor that stuff.
Back.
I ride stronger more so than tugger. Like step to my wrist and ride that horse in the frame. Or ride into that frame. Right there. Now soft. Now be ready, just check your wrist, you know, like stiffen up your wrist, stiffen up your hole when that horse goes to push against you. And then ride through it. That doesn't mean you pull back harder, it just means you set a block with your hand. That horse will make enough discomfort for itself pushing against the barrier, so then I'll ride the body into that barrier. If you sit down and you pull hard at that point, the horse is already having a problem. So when you pull hard, sometimes you get them overall. There you go, that's like, there you go, very nice. A lot nicer. So if he's going to do anything with his head, I want it to come to me, not go away. I try not to let him get out past that birdie, if I could. Don't take me to reach out to birdie, because I don't want him getting out past it at this point. I'm trying to teach him this type of lesson.
Looks good, interesting.
Okay, now the other thing I'd like to see you do is when you go to the stops, over bridle this horse some and then sit down and try and hold that frame into that stop. Yes? Yeah, do it somewhere so it's side on to me so I can see. So I want you to make sure that horse's nose is coming down to you, not going up in the air like that. Keep your hands down. Keep going around when you get the horse in the shape you want.
Needs to be tired out.
That is good. That is not good. Right there is good. Oh, good. Now hold. And you're holding to that horse. He relaxes that lower jaw and stops moving. Now be careful you're not continuing to pull when that horse gets. Keep your hands stacked where they are. He's going to make his own slack. When he makes his own slack, you can't keep taking them. There you go. That's good. Now let's do it again. Let's try to make sure do that again.
Stop it.
Straighten him up, make him go forward. There you go, good. Good, now stop him there. Whoa. And then just stick and hold. Then you stop him doing. Then you figure out where he's going to go with his head and his lower jaw in order to get some comfort in that ride.
Can't say anything to Lori.
Okay, let's try it again and do it again.